Alright, so what we have here today is a 56-inch Hampton Bay industrial ceiling fan. This particular fan dates to 2015. And you're probably wondering, wait, this is actually a Hampton Bay industrial? And yes, I want to say. This fan here is like new condition. I do have the original box, which is right here. I believe this style of box was perhaps maybe an online only style box, you know, shipped directly from a warehouse, not sold in store. As you can tell, there's no Hampton Bay brand, but this style of box, I've seen actual Hampton Bay labeled fans under this and with this same box, such as the Farmington, the Middleton, the Littleton, and others. Box is quite beat up. Unfortunately, the guy I got this from off eBay did a pretty crap job packing it, so I'll get into more of that here in a minute. 7600 CFM rating. You can see there, distributed by Home Depot. It's a pretty standard basic box. You'll notice right here, made in India. That's pretty odd. Yeah, this fan is definitely not like the Hampton Bay industrials we're familiar with. Like I said, this thing here is actually made in India. Show you where the label was hiding at. There it is. According to the UL file number on this thing's actually manufactured by Orient Electric from India. The motor on this thing is pretty interesting. It has either a cast aluminum or cast zinc top plate with a blade attached. The bottom plate is actually just a cover. You can see it's held on with screws there on the side of the motor. That's stamped steel. Within it, it has a cast zinc, you know, skeletal cradle where it holds the lower bearing in place. The motor is roughly 172 in diameter. Ball socket mount. The blades on the fan are stamped aluminum. Pretty thin stamped aluminum. Quite flimsy. And these blades are some of the lightest industrial blades I've ever seen. Riveted onto stamped steel blade irons. But yeah, this fan was a little bit damaged in shipping when I got it. It's hard to tell now, but there was a decent sized dent in this cover. Surprisingly, the blades were pretty much unscathed. They were packaged in their own separate box. The top lip of the canopy was kind of tweaked. But the biggest casualty of it all was the included 4-speed wall control. Capacitor base, but you can tell there's a capacitor missing. And what we have here is the missing capacitor. Broke clean off. Now, I personally, I'm not going to even try to repair that. So, that wall control is just going to have to be chalked up as DOA, dead on arrival. So, we're going to be using a 5-speed wall control in its place to demonstrate the fan width. So without further ado, let's go ahead and see what this thing does. Start it up here on low. I don't have any packaging or any instructions or paperwork with this thing. Those are all missing. This was a open box deal. I'm pretty sure the fan was missing its entire top half. It's missing the top half of the styrofoam packaging, which led to it being so damaged when it got here. And another thing to note is that the downrod on this fan is not original. That's a downer that the seller from eBay included, but it's not the original one that came with this fan. The original downrod would have been 15 inches long. And a pretty quite specific downrod as well, which has a notch in the lower end of it where it attaches to the motor so the wires can slip up through within and up through the downrod. So the eBay seller threw that 6-inch one in there, and I actually had to modify by filing out the ring of the retainer coupler and the lower canopy to even to get that thing to fit on there. So yeah. All kinds of issues. Take it to speed number 2. Speed number 3. Speed number 4. And speed number 5. Full tilt. As you can see, this thing's not totally obscenely fast like some industrials are. However, it's still moving a pretty decent sum of air. I would say the blade pitch on this thing is actually a bit steeper than some industrials I've encountered. Likely we're doing somewhere in the realm of 200-210 RPM. It's not the most powerful industrial out there. Like I said, this fan has a 7600 CFM rating. The other Hampton Bay industrial that was sold at this time that we are very familiar with, made by PowerMax, those have the plastic gossamer wind design blades. Those things have a 10,000 CFM rating. So, yeah, those things blow this out of the water. Now, I'd say a Dayton leading edge in this same size probably outperforms this thing as well. But it's certainly not the worst I've encountered. The Menards turn of the century industrial is... Whew, that thing is atrocious. Very early on, SMC actually manufactured industrials for Hampton Bay. Hampton Bay just relabeled the SMC K56. And sometime around 2000, 2001, So when they came out with their Power Max Industrial, earlier ones were labeled under Commercial Electric. Then later on they were labeled Hampton Bay. Then this thing probably only lasted probably a year or two, if I would have guessed. This is the only one I've ever seen. So pretty unique. It's got a pretty nice upward sweep blade pitch to it like that. Almost reminds me of a lot of the Crompton Greaves fans, also made in India. So, that's all I got for this one. So, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video on this 56-inch white Hampton Bay industrial ceiling fan, manufactured by Orient Electric from India. So, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. Peace.